2022 season began in New Zealand. Mi Hang Lee took the ISBS Handa New Zealand Open with a final round course record 63. Then it was on to the Gold Coast in Australia and the Volvic RACV Masters, where Cheyenne Woods outshone the field for her maiden victory. Tiger's niece holding a nerve until the end to win by two strokes. The next stop was Mission Hills in China, where world number one Imbi Park continued her dominant form. Her five-stroke World Championship victory included a third round 62. The 20th edition of the Lala Meriem Cup in Morocco seemed to be Gladys Nocera's for the taking. But she reckoned without the teenage English sensation Charlie Hull. She won a playoff for her first title. The first of many, no doubt. Now the tour has moved to Turkey for the sixth Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. Balek is on the southern coast. It's one of the country's top tourist destinations with plenty to do for all the family. A strong field has gathered to take on the tough, pretty and highly rated National Golf Course. The favourite to take the title is the Order of Merit leader Charlie Hull. At a lavish party for the players before the tournament, Hull reflected on her success in Morocco and looked forward to taking on the National.
Get my win out of the way, and now it's just kind of, I had a good few good starts this season, just working on my game, you know, and just keep on playing golf and enjoy it. I want to try and get another win in, because now I've got the bug for it, but you know, just keep on practicing, enjoying it as well. So I think that's the key.
These are live pictures from the National Golf Course in Belek in southern Turkey. Let's have a look at the Order of Merit going into the tournament. Charlie Hull leading Gladys Nocera. Also here, Trish Johnson and Sophie Jaquel Bettin. Alongside myself, Nigel Bidmead, is Richard Kaufman. A very good afternoon to you, Richard.
Yeah, very good afternoon. Very much looking forward to this afternoon's play here in Belek. This National Golf Club is a real test for these players, and some of them have found some struggles. You can't take any of your eyes off it, really, because there's no comfort out there at all. You can see from some of the shots we're looking at here, very tree-lined course, lots of trouble everywhere. And if you're not driving the ball well particularly, then you're going to find it very difficult to score here.
Changeable weather conditions throughout this opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. We have had a bit of rain, and there is some more changeable weather forecast throughout the weekend. Prize fund, €250,000. There we have the weather conditions.
I've got to say, Nigel, it's a lot better than when we looked at the forecast yesterday. The forecast really for the whole week was for thunderstorms to hit around this kind of time of day. Fortunately, the winds died. There is rain in the air, as it's saying on that graphic there, but thankfully at the moment, in terms of thunder and lightning, hopefully, fingers crossed, it's going to evade the golf course and we should have a full day's play.
These are going to be our featured players this afternoon. Trish Johnson, Laura Davis, Holly Clyburn, Florentina Parker of England, and the two French ladies, Gladys Nocera and Valentine Derry. Let's bring you up to speed with some of the earlier play during the day. Charlie Hull, one of the early starters.
Yeah, well, she had one birdie, one bogey on her front nine, starting at the 10th. And at the par five, the fourth hole, picked up another birdie, and she was going really nicely, Charlie. After birdie in the first and second, she did drop one at five. Another one went at six, but that's how she reacts. She has no fear. She doesn't know the meaning of the word setback. And how about this, an approach into her closing hole of the day, the ninth, 386-yard par four, put it within birdie range, and we knew what was coming next, Nigel.
Well, it's another birdie, and Charlie Hull ending strongly.
Yeah, round of 70 for Charlie, 3-under par for here. Unfortunately for Leanne Pace, what an up and down day for the defending champion. Started with a couple of bogeys. She then birdied four in a row just after the turn. But she had a triple bogey seven at this hole, the sixth. She hated the tee shot. It clattered into the trees. She found it difficult to get it out of there. And in the end, she had to settle for a 3-over par round of 75.
Sara Hassan of Wales, birdie putt on 14, very much in the mix. A good morning for the Welsh lady.
Yeah, round of 71 for her, leaves it 2-under par. And talking of young ladies, this 19-year-old from the Czech Republic, Klára Spuková. This is her approach shot to the eighth in a round that included five birdies and just the one drop shot. A round of 69, and she goes looking for her first Ladies European Tour victory. And she's very much in the mix, isn't she, at 4-under par.
So here's the leaderboard as it stands right now. And a surprise at the top. Heather McRae of Scotland, the 30-year-old, shooting the lights out, 6-under par, 67.
Yeah, just one shot off the course record. McRae leading from Spuková. Michaela Palmley, that's an incredible story as well. She hung up the clubs at the end of last season. She got a call from the LPGA to play in that International Crown tournament that's coming up in a month or so. So she decided she'll start playing again. First tournament back, round of 69, 4-under par. And she's just two shots off the lead.
Great stuff. Charlie Hull in there, as we mentioned. Holly Clyburn as well.
Yeah, what a fabulous start from Holly. It's almost like Holly and Charlie's careers go side by side. Of course, one played in the Solheim Cup, the other didn't, but had very similar seasons last year.
With Holly Clyburn, the first to win a tournament, taking the Dutch Open. So Charlie Hull winning in Morocco last time out.
Well, mention Holly Clyburn being at 3-under par. She's playing in the group with Valentine Derry, who is in your picture right now from France, and Laura Davis, who, as we'll get to see, has had a pretty horrific start to her opening round.
Been in really good form, Derry, so far this season. Six rounds in the 60s. Top 20 finish here last year.
As you can see, it's probably raining as heavy as it has done all day. There was a few trickles about this morning. It was certainly a little breezier this morning as well. Winds, well, not too strong, 10, 15 miles an hour, but it's almost dead still. And here's Holly Clyburn, who's leading the chase, if you like, from the afternoon starters. Had a terrific start, birdied the first, the third. Just recently picked up one at seven as well. And she's in perfect position here to strike into this ninth hole. Like quite a few of these holes at this golf course, designed by David Fairty and David Jones. A lot of two-tier greens, a lot of contours on them.
I think it's fair to call it a bit quirky, isn't it?
Yes.
And it's certainly challenging. Here's Clyburn with her second shot. She's one of the bigger hitters on tour.
And using the slope perfectly there. Excellent chance for another birdie. If she can pop that in, she'll go to the turn in just 32 shots.
She's dialed in.
And she defends her title in a couple of weeks. And you can see her sister there is her caddy today and the rest of the week. India.
She's a good golfer too, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a very good amateur. Won a few tournaments. Of course, her sister, Holly, was in the Curtis Cup. And they just announced the Curtis Cup team, didn't they, this week? Now, Laura, what an awful start. Started double bogey at one or two. She's given another shot away since then as well. And I'm afraid, you can only call it a nightmare scenario. You can see the leaders there, six under par for Heather McRae. Well, Laura Davis right now is 11 shots off the lead. And incredibly, she started double bogey. In the group behind, Melissa Reed, who is, of course, a former winner here, did exactly the same.
You look at that, some of the big names having problems on this course.
You look at Nigel, that opening hole, you wouldn't believe that.
Well, we saw a couple hit the trees in that when we were walking around, didn't we? It's tight.
Well, Laura felt she was actually been playing quite well the last few weeks. If anything, it's been her putting that's let her down, but she's obviously been off track a few times. And she's down the right-hand side as well on this ninth hole. Now, Laura normally plays at a very quick place, so I've got a feeling she's waiting for a referee here, because Laura sees it, grips it and rips it. And for her to be waiting here suggests to me that she's waiting for some kind of ruling.
I'm not sure that she's waiting for the green to clear, because I don't think she has a line into the green, so...
Well, while she waits for a ruling, take you back to the 10th hole.
Florentina Parker, who likes this golf course and has done well here over the years. This is her tee shot. And safely to the middle of the fairway.
Yeah, you're right about her record here. Sixth last year and tied fourth and tied second. So yeah, she is waiting. You can see Laura's yellow ball. She likes playing with the yellow ball there, just in the right-hand rough. Now, unless there may be...
she does have a line. Well, I don't know. What do you think that's about?
Well, she's obviously looking for a way to maybe try and... maybe there's a tree there that's maybe not fully grown that she feels she can get relief from. I'm not too sure. We obviously don't have anyone out on the course to tell us, but obviously Laura knows the game inside out, and she'll be waiting for the chance maybe to give her a little bit of relief there. And she needs some light relief after that horror start that she's had. I was speaking to her last night. She feels she's been playing pretty well. She missed the cut last week in the United States in Dallas, but that was generally down to poor putting, and she's put a new putter back in her bag, one of her old putters. Trish Johnson just bounced back, first birdie of the day at the
really
eighth
consistent
hole.
Start to the season from Trish Johnson. A couple of top 10 finishes, including last time out in Morocco.
Well, there's only one bunker on this hole, and you can see it there, just beyond Trish's left leg, front left portion of this screen. Unlike quite a few of the others, it's a fairly flat green. And I mentioned that bunker. Unfortunately, Trish has found it. Couple over, three bogeys in her first five holes. She won on the Tartan Tour a few weeks ago. Ladies Tartan Tour. Quite a few of the players from the British Isles that play on the Ladies European Tour went and played in that one.
There has been a gap which has allowed them to play golf on other tours, as Florentina Parker just makes it over the bunker.
Yeah, interesting. You look at someone like Clara Spilkova, who's done well this morning. She obviously played last week in the Access Tour event. And it is difficult for these young ladies. They 8 weeks without competitive golf on the Ladies European Tour. Some of them would have been in good form in Morocco, would have liked to have had a few events in a row. Others probably happy for the gap and use the time to practice well. Of course, Nocera is one of those that did play well in that last event. So close to winning, but of course, Charlie Holt memorably pipped her.
Good control from Gladys Nocera.
Well, we know now why Laura is waiting. There was a sponsor board up there that was in the way of where she wants to put this. Now she's going to try and cut this one low and under the tree. She's done pretty well.
She's done very well.
Maybe she's always entertaining, off. Isn't she, Laura?
Was she in good form last night?
No, because she's a Liverpool supporter and she was watching Manchester City win, so she wasn't happy about that as far as the title race was concerned. That apart, yeah, she was in good form. Hoping that she might join us in the commentary box tomorrow.
As Richard said, cut it round the tree. Oh, she didn't have much to aim at, did she?
And she's had a top 20 this year on the LPGA Tour. She really does still believe she can win 50 now, which of course in the men's game means time to cash in on the Champions Tour in the United States. Of course, there is a Legends Tour, but Laura still feels she can win, well, both sides of the Atlantic.
Now, Tris Johnson from the greenside bunker on the 10th.
It'll be interesting to see what the winning score is here this week. We've got, of course, McRae in the clubhouse with that fabulous round of 67, 6 under par. But during the years, 6 under par, which is where she is right now, that'd be good enough to win you it. There's only been couple of years in this, the sixth edition now, where 7 under par has won it. Otherwise, it's been 2-3 under par that's been good enough.
Laura Davis chipping.
But they have made a few changes, haven't they, Nigel?
I think there's been quite a few over the years, yeah.
I mean, they've cleared away a few of the overhanging branches.
Last 12 months has been a few too, yeah. Tried to make it slightly easier, I think. Well, slightly more open.
Yeah, I think the fairways are tight enough as it is. If you put some overhanging branches in the way as well, it makes them even tighter. But if you're striking the ball well, tee to green, well, you're going to give yourself birdie chances, and that's exactly what Holly Clyburn's been doing so far here this afternoon. This is a chance for birdie number 4.
To go 4 under. Left herself one coming back to Florentina Parker. Putting from the fringe. And Parker will have that for par.
Well, this is for par for Laura. We saw a second shot just go to the left-hand edge of the green. Putted to here. And, well, she told me the putter she's got playing with today is called the yes putter. I'm afraid it was the no putter there, because it's led to another bogey. And she's gone to the turn in 6 over par. Nasera, meanwhile, has another birdie chance. Finished 12th here last year, Gladys, even though she started with a round of 81, which maybe is the kind of message Laura Davis needs to hear right now at 6 over par at the turn, because you will see some big numbers on this course, and even big numbers doesn't mean you're going to miss the cut. Nasera doesn't have to worry about that today, but Laura obviously at 6 over does.
Clyburn safely home for par. Stays 3 under. Johnson trying to get up and down. That makes it very solid.
There's no doubt about it. The back nine, you feel like there are scoring opportunities out there. 3 par fives coming in 4 holes from the 12th. Not saying they're birdie guarantees, And obviously when there's a par five in view, you do feel there's an opportunity. Parker mopping up, stays two under, four off the lead.
In a very good position, Florentina Parker. In the early stages of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. Heather McRae has her nose in front. She has a two-shot lead on the opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open.
So the scoring pretty good, isn't it, in this first round in comparison to previous years?
Well, last year when Leanne Pace won at 3 under, there were only 5 rounds in the 60s, and that's how tough it was. And I think, you know, when you look at the leaderboard, I mean, Heather McRae, what a storming round of golf from her.
Well, Nocera and her group have reached the par 3 11th, 143 yards in place today, pin over just over on the right-hand side. You can see, protected by that deep front bunker.
The hardest working member of the Ladies European Tour, played in every tournament last year.
Says
she doesn't like it.
If looks could kill. And she's left herself a very awkward spot there. That's going to be a tough up and down.
She's got some tape on her left shoulder. And I wonder if that's causing her a problem.
Well, it doesn't seem to be in terms of the way she's been playing and scoring so far. Her and Florentina Parker have been going along very nicely. And you do feel the horses for courses. Of course, if you look at previous editions of this tournament, Parker's played so, so well here. And Crystal Burleon, who's playing this year mainly in America, is another who's played so well here in the past, won it a couple of times. Parker's knocked on the door, but she's also left herself in an awkward spot. Sixth on the order of merit right now, Trish, which is testament to...
Sorry, what did you say?
She's sixth. You listen.
Sixth. Yeah, I was listening.
Sixth on the order of merit, Nigel.
She's had a very good start to the season, very good first quarter of the season. Welcome back to coverage of the opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. Trish Johnson on the 11th tee box, and I'm not sure she likes that either.
Yeah, well, she's on the dance floor. Her playing partners have gone through the back of the green, Florentina Parker and Gladys Nocera, and they've left themselves in pretty awkward spots there. It's an elevated green, but conditions right now, well, they're pretty good really. The greens are sticking, the balls are rolling nicely on this course designed by the Davids, Fairty and Jones,
the Ulstermen.
It's a golf course that's busy in terms of tournament play. Next week they've got the Challenge Tour coming here, and of course later in the year they play the Ladies European Tour Access Series, one of the events towards the end of the season here as well. So it sees plenty of activity, and of course down the road you've got the Montgomery course, where part of the final series action on the European Tour will be played. They like that one from Laura Davis at 10. She needs a good back nine. She can kind of start again, having turned in six over par. Hopefully Laura can play with a little bit of freedom, find her game, and maybe find a few birdies. Three par fives on this back nine, so a real chance maybe for Laura to use her hitting power to some advantage.
Back to the 11th, and Sarah's tee shot ran away through the back of the green. And
well, she hated it, didn't she, Nigel? Let's be honest about it. She played some lovely golf today, but
she did.
Then she was disgusted with herself, and she's left herself in that tricky spot. Be tough up and down from there.
Did she chunk that? Well, it stayed out of the bunker, but work to do for Valentine Derry.
Davis, perfect drive down here. Now, can she put one in close? She can. It's amazing, isn't it, the mindset. You start a new nine holes, it's almost like, right, time to start again. And I think Laura's,
you have a little chat with yourself,
yeah,
don't you?
Laura's experienced enough, wily enough to know, even at six over par, given the kind of course that she's playing on, that if she can just make a little run on the back nine, she can put herself at least in with a chance. It's a long way back, mind you.
Parker on 11. I was hoping that was going to roll down the hill towards the pin, but it has stopped well short. To Clyburn.
Yeah, fairway missed here at 9, but if you're going to miss the fairway, better to be down this left-hand side rather at 10 than over on the right. Another one that looks at the ground after hitting it. Pretty good result, though. But there is a bit of moisture around. No preferred lies today, but there is forecast for some really heavy rain later on this evening, so I wouldn't be surprised if that is the case tomorrow.
Johnson for birdie.
It's great, isn't it? 47, Trish. It's 27 years since she was the Rookie of the Year, yet there she is still in the top 10 of the Order of Merit, still performing really well. She suffered a little bit with for injuries for a while, but I think she's feeling pain-free at the moment, and it's great to see her playing some really good golf.
Parker for par. Oh, well done. A lovely putt from Florentina Parker after that short chip shot. Yeah, it's worth a smile.
Yeah, but it keeps the bogeys off the card, and that's really important for momentum, isn't it? It's not one of those courses where it's easy to go around bogey-free. In fact, you'll see very few rounds where that is the case, and it's those kind of putts that just give you the chance to go out and shoot a score in the 60s.
Half a Johnson. Perhaps she might view that as an opportunity missed, but she walks off with a par. Here's Derry.
Just to let you know, Gladys Nocera also got up and down there, so three good pars in the end from Johnson, Gladys Nocera and Florentina Parker. It is one of the toughest courses on the Ladies European Tour schedule. I mean, it's not necessarily that long. It's only 6,142 yards, par 73, but it's just the tightness of it.
There's a lot of water too.
Yeah, but you stand on the tee sometimes and it's, I mean, I walked, for example, that first hole, which we haven't seen yet today, where they're landing it, I walked across the fairway. It was 13 paces only across the fairway at the narrow point. I mean, that's like, I've been through some tunnels there wider than that.
This is an interesting hole, is it, Nigel, this par 5, 12?
It is.
You don't often see a top player like Gladys Nocera hitting an iron off a tee at a par 5. There is a reason, isn't there?
Well, there's a little brook that runs across the fairway, but they will get a 3-wood, a 5-wood maybe out for their second shot.
But I find it quite bizarre in a way. I don't think Laura will be taking an iron out here, not given the way that she's been going. I'll be interested to see what she does in the next group, because it's, I mean, they're laying up off the tee basically 160 yards with their tee shot. I mean, it's what, 230 yards really you need to carry it?
215 would get you over.
Over, yeah, but yeah. 230 to get to the meat of the fairway. And that's why you can see 6-iron there is all what it was for Florentina Parker, and Trish also coming out with the iron. It'd be interesting to see if Laura does take out the driver and bang it over. Just doesn't feel right, does it? Going with a 6-iron off a par 5.
I think on this course, course management is at a premium. I think some of the longer hitters will fancy taking this on.
Well, Clyburn wasn't too happy with their second in here, but it is another birdie opportunity. Fairways and greens. That's what she's been doing so far. Never had the legs.
Now, Laura Davis. To put her trials and tribulations behind her.
No, and not good for the mindset, that one. I felt if she could just roll in a birdie there at 10, we might see a terrific comeback, particularly with those par fives I've been mentioning coming up, but not to be. Still without a birdie today.
Derry for par. Nice strike.
Well, Holly has to mop up here. Of course, all the headlines about Charlie Holt. By some, she kind of got forgotten about, really, didn't she, Holly? But she only finished one place behind Charlie Holt on the Order of Merit. Unlike Charlie, she did actually win last season. But you can understand the euphoria with Charlie Holt. I mean, she's an incredible talent. But Holly, she goes about her business quietly, and she has some talent herself, doesn't she?
And I wonder if flying under the radar helps in keeping the pressure off when you're just starting out on your career.
Those were the days. Sun was shining. Hey, Nigel, this was
nice
yesterday.
Nice day yesterday. Yes. Yeah.
There's a few players who've seen too much of those trees.
Now, Sarah assessing her options on 12. It'll be Florentina Parker to play first. Fairway metal in hand. Trying to work it from right to left.
Yeah, and then the third shot they have is severely uphill.
But, it's a very only, raised green, isn't it?
Yeah, only with a wedge in their hands, but 6-iron, 3-wood wedge. She has become, again, such a consistent performer, Nocera. You expect her, I suppose, in the same way as we expect Clyburn and the likes of Charlie Hull to be up there, you always expect Gladys to be knocking on the door as well. And a terrific 2013.
She's certainly one of the contenders this week. Around.
Well, this hole seems to be deceiving the players a little. That's this last group we saw two balls go through the back of the green.
Was that an error in club selection, do you think? The swing looked okay.
I think she pulled it slightly. Laura, who doesn't tee it up, just puts it on the ground, hits away and hits it hole high.
Valentine Derry was first to go in this group, and this was her tee shot on 11. She has the measure of the 11th. It's a lovely shot. Lovely rhythm from Valentine Derry.
Well, there are birdie chances out there on this back nine. We had five of them from our leader, Heather McRae, earlier on today. Fabulous round from Heather, whose dad is the top golf pro at Glen Eagles Hotel. Of course, there's a big tournament going up there in September.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
I'm sure we're all looking forward to the Ryder Cup, and I'm sure... the McRae's will be right in the thick of the action there, because with Heather's dad being the golf pro at Glen Eagles. But it's really good to see her progressing. She played very well, Heather, in 2013, won on the Access Tour. Just missed out on getting her card that way. And this back at the par 5 12th, and Trish Johnson, unfortunately, with a three, went down towards the trees. I think she might have got a little fortunate here and found a route through.
Backing into a tree, though.
Yeah, it's just slightly impeding her backswing.
You can see how raised the green is.
They've made a few changes to this green. They've actually relayed it since 2013. They've taken out a mound in front of the green. The slopes are less severe. It's given the organisers here an opportunity to put in a few more different pin positions to the ones they could last year. The course is generally in very good condition. Been very few complaints from the players. You know the players, they like a complaint or two.
Parker, two under. Ooh. She's misjudged that one.
And let's see the short game touch of Holly Kleiber. Pretty good, isn't it?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
With a lot of practice. She's been out in Florida the last couple of weeks, and a little bit of sunshine on her back, good place for you to practice your short game. I'm sure she's tried a few of those over the last few weeks.
So committed to the stroke, wasn't she? Yes. Nocera eyes up her approach shot on the 12th.
Yeah, incredibly, both her and Parker are bogey free today. Chris Johnson had three in her first five holes, so it's not all of the group who have kept the blemishes away.
Right on the money from Nocera. That sets up a birdie opportunity.
5 win this year, is back in the winner's circle with a couple of W's in 2013. So close, wasn't she, in Morocco. But with this kind of wedge, she has got it dialed in, and a terrific opportunity for her to get to 3 under par now, and just 3 shots off the lead.
Checks on the second bounce.
If anything with Gladys, you just feel it's the putter where she needs to fire to win. She can be a really streaky putter. With her week, she can win by a few shots.
I think it stayed up.
Yeah, more disappointment for Laura. Birdie free through 11 holes. It must be gut-wrenching. You go out with high hopes, her and Melissa Reed, and you take a 7 at the par 5, you take a 5 at the par 3, and suddenly you're chasing.
I think that's what we mentioned. It's very easy to get away from you on this golf course with an errant iron. Now, this is tricky for Trish Johnson.
Yeah, I suppose the question for her is how far does she put it on the green and let the contours take it down to the hole? One of those when you're standing there, because you've got a good view of it, as Trish will have standing perched up on that hill, where you actually fancy chipping it in. I'm surprised actually she hasn't taken the flag out, but it's one of those, of course, that you just get a little clumsy, it can get away with you from you and end up trickling 10-15 feet past. Oh, it's lovely. Didn't quite
expertly
chip it in,
done.
But she wasn't far away, was she?
No, that was a very awkward shot. Now, Derry to get back to level par after that very controlled tee shot. Horseshoes in for Valentine Derry. She's back to level par. Laura Davis made her par with a tap-in. Parker, who went through the back of the 12th green. This is for birdie. And she'll have that for par.
Parker shows, I mean, she's been close here many times. There's certain courses you'll turn up to in the year and you'll think, yeah, I fancy my chances this week.
Yeah.
Excellent up and down from Clyburn. Stays at 3 under. And a little high five with sister India. I wonder if India's giving her clubs this week or she's merely there as a bag carrier. I suppose she probably knows Holly's game pretty well.
That ball belongs to Gladys Nacera. Three under.
Well done. Mm. I mean, you've got to have a strong mindset, haven't you? 8 weeks she's waited to try and put the wrongs of Morocco right. 3 putting the last hole for a bogey that allowed Charlie Hull, of course, to, with that wonderful 62, you have to say, to get into the playoff with her.
Yeah.
But do you know what I mean? Gladys, I'm sure, will feel that should have been another
week.
She'd
have been
for me.
Chomping at the bit.
And then you've got
she?
To wait 8 weeks for the next event.
Yeah.
It's tough, isn't it?
Parker for par. Safely negotiated. Heather McRae of Scotland continues to lead the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open by two shots from Klára Spilková of the Czech Republic.
Yeah, good to see someone like Vicky Lang as well performing well here today. She shot a round of two under par and not as good as the lady leading the way. Seven birdies today, Nigel, from Heather McRae.
It's a really good performance.
So a round of six under today, what a fantastic start to the tournament for you.
Yeah, it was really pleasing. It's nice to get out early on the first day and I hold a good putt for par on 10 and then birdied the next couple of holes. So it just kind of tried to stay calm and take one shot at a time and it's turned out pretty good. So
this is a course you actually know a little bit better than many. You did well here in the Access Series. In fact, almost a repeat on the first day then as the first day now.
Yeah, I played November last year in the Access Tour and I think the first round is some of the best golf that I've played. So it was, I think that helped me a lot today with standing on the tees and knowing that I've hit good shots and hit good shots into the greens. And yeah, it's a nice place. It's a great golf course and it's just got a nice feel about it. So
that's a big event and you're winning by two shots currently, I believe. But you seem so relaxed. Are you really relaxed or is this just an act for me?
No, I am, but I think it's good because, as I say, when I was here in the Access event last year and I was leading after the first day and kind of getting a tour card was hanging in the balance, I got so kind of stuck in the moment and just got so nervous. So I mean, it's only Thursday, I have to remember that and there's still a long way to go and there's still people just teeing off just now. So it's a bit early to get excited.
We'll get excited for you. Thanks for your time.
Well, she should be very proud, shouldn't she, Nigel, of that effort. And when you think, she's talking about that the final event here last year on the Access Tour was here at this golf course, and she ended up missing out on her card by one shot. 40 points she missed out on the top five by one shot. You think of a whole season, and it comes down to one putt, one maybe one missed putt from a couple of feet somewhere around the world. It's incredible what it comes down to, but she's made amends so far today here, hasn't she?
Had to go back to qualifying school. Finished outside the top 30 in Morocco. But making the most of her opportunity here in Belek.
Yeah, she's right. It's only round one. A long way to go.
Trish Johnson on the 13th tee. Two over par, the veteran Englishwoman, and she's missed the fairway.
Well, we wondered, didn't we? We speculated, would Laura Davis bang it over that little water hazard that creeps off around this 12th fairway? Well, she did.
We think this is Holly Clyburn's third shot because she too went with driver. And I don't think she made it over the hazard. So confirmation of that to come. So the 12th claims another victim. And we wait to see where the driver of Laura Davis landed. So well, it's three wood, I think.
Yeah, this was a tee shot, obviously, a moment or two ago from Holly Clyburn. And in she went. You're not going to be able to pick that one out. But no such problems for Laura, who boomed it over.
Maybe that's what she needs to get something going in her round.
Well, I think. I mean, I don't think there was even a question mark whether she would try and smack it. Given the fact that she's six over par particularly, there's nothing to protect, she may as well
that's
go
the way
for
she
it.
Plays the game.
Yeah, I say that. Even if she did have something to protect, she'd still take the driver out and try and knock it over. Now, can she knock it close? Let's give herself an eagle opportunity. Well, it's not close, but it's on the green.
And she's on the green for two.
Not an easy putt, mind you, coming up and over that slope. But, wow, surely a first birdie of the day coming up.
The oldest player in the field by 3 months, from Laurette Maritz of South Africa, who we saw when we were walking around earlier today.
Yeah, another one that we saw having some fun and games around the trees. Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't think this course particularly would suit Laura Davis's game, but she has played well here in the past, 12th last year, 19th in 2012.
Tied 8th in 2010 as well in the second edition.
You see, the rough isn't too penal for the players here, but obviously ball very much above Trish's feet. Into the bunker.
More sand.
Yeah, the problem is when the sand starts to get wet, as it is now, there's a chance it could plug.
Sticks to the ball, doesn't it, as well?
But thankfully, she did come out of where she landed there. But she's struggling a little bit with her game at the moment, Trish, from what we've seen. Made a good par at the last, getting up and down. She'll look to do the same here.
Derry on the 12th to the raised green.
Yeah, playing it in the conventional manner. Line off the tee, laying up, and then the third over the flag.
Very consistent season last season from Valentine Derry. 10th in the order of merit. Got herself in a bit of a pickle on this hole as Holly Clyburn. Going to have to manufacture a shot to get out of it.
No, she hit the tree. She just hit the tree. She is having a bit of a nightmare. You can see her ball there. It's gone right across the fairway and into the right-hand side rough. So she's there for four, and now she is throwing a big number in here, the possibility, Holly Clyburn. All that hard work, giving herself birdie chance after birdie chance, and it was just, well, I suppose the gamble of going with the driver off the tee, finding the water, and she's now compounded the error, hasn't she? Her layup wasn't good. She's hit the tree with her next.
Sarah, her approach to the par 4 13th. Very, very tidy from Nasera. Now, does Holly Clyburn have the temperament to cope with this setback?
Well, I think the answer to that, from what we've seen of her young career, is yes, she can. She's had a few setbacks. I mean, you think to the girls at the Curtis Cup a couple of years ago after the first day nightmare they had, the way they returned from that. Holly is a very stubborn, if you like, but very determined player.
She's a competitor.
Yeah, I wouldn't surprise me if she got up and down here. Well, having said that, not from there she won't.
Well, no control out of the wet rough.
Well, she's certainly staring a double bogey in the face now, isn't she, Clyburn?
Parker to the 13th. That clipped a tree.
Yeah, it was a good break, really. It could have gone easily off the tree and to the left, but it kicked into the bunker.
Still, the rain falls steadily. As Laura Davis wanders up to have a look at the hole on 12, she's got a ridge to go over. In the meantime, we'll go back to Florentina Parker, who is in a greenside bunker on the hole ahead. That was a difficult lie, and she's still in it. It came straight down and must have plugged, but here's Parker again. That goes some way towards rescuing the situation.
Well, look at the stance here for Trish Johnson, having to try and dig her feet in. At least she came out of her plug mark, unlike Florentina Parker, it would have seemed, who had a very tricky night. Not bad.
Sarah just removing some sand from her line, maybe a pine needle or two, and it'll be Trish Johnson first to go. Back to Holly Clyburn.
Yeah, she's made a few bad errors, hasn't she, on this hole. Has to do no worse than two putt from here. It looks like she'll do that, but it'll be a double bogey that'll take her from within striking distance. She was of Heather McRae to five back at one under. But that's one of the good things about this golf course, that I think David Fairty and David Jones have done such a good job when they did design this, albeit 20 years ago, is that if you play really good golf like Heather McRae has done today, you can find some birdies out there. I think the taking away of a few hanging branches that just widened the course a little, just made it a little fairer. But if, like Laura Davis at the start of the day, or you saw there from Holly Clyburn just now on the 12th, you start making errors, you are going to be punished. Come on, Laura, first birdie of the day.
To go five over.
Oh. Yeah, it's one of those days. Well, she admits it, her putting's been letting her down, and we've seen her have a couple of good birdie opportunities, haven't we, at 10 and now again at 12 that she's failed to take. Yeah, it's all very well changing your putter, but if you haven't got the confidence that you're going to hold putts, then you won't.
Now this needs to drop for Holly Clyburn. It's a double bogey. She drops a couple of shots. Goes back to one under. Florentina Parker.
Yeah, this for bogey, unfortunately, after taking two out of the bunker. And unfortunately, it's another we see make a double. But it's going to be a feature we see, I think, throughout the week here. Players going along swimmingly well, and suddenly they're tripped.
Well, we've seen a couple of double bogeys in the last couple of minutes. Unforgiving, this golf course.
Can anyone catch Heather McRae at the end of round one? It seems unlikely with Holly Clyburn slip up there at the par 5 12th. Gladys Cicera now the leader of the afternoon chases. Valentin Derry.
Trying to cut off the corner.
Yeah, there's a straight down par four. There is some water over on the right hand side, but it really isn't in play. It's the water that's to the right of the 16th green. Any hits driver probably in four or five holes around here, Davis. Obviously, no need for her to take it out here. I think the next time we'll see it from Laura will probably be at the 15th hole. Three wood from Clyburn.
Going off the back of that double bogey. Oh, that's wayward too.
Well, suddenly the wheels have come off, haven't they, for Holly Clyburn?
She has a decent lie, but to see if she has room to swing the club when she gets there. This is the situation on the opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. A superb round of golf from Heather McRae. Top efforts too from Klara Spilkova of the Czech Republic and Mikaela Palmlid of Sweden, both breaking 70 on one of the toughest golf courses on tour, but lurking. Charlie Hull, and still out on the course, Gladys Nocera, three shots off the lead. Rebecca Hudson and Sara Hassan, two under par 71s for them. So too Vicky Lang of Scotland, Florentina Parker, another Englishwoman going well.
Yeah, good to see Rebecca Codd going well. She did get it to 3 under par through her first five holes, but she dropped a shot at the par 5 15th, but gone to the turn in a couple under, the Irish girl. Yeah, Sarah Hassan. It's also a good story there to see the Welsh girl there at 2 under par. Very keen young tennis player she was. Got to play at Wimbledon, so I understand.
Got her dad on the bag this week.
Nice to see Vicky Lang starting to return to some kind of form after her wrist injury problems. Oh dear, Gladys has put herself in a problematic situation here. Well, caddy's mopping up there in front of her to suggest that she's going to try and find
underneath,
that little gap.
Maybe.
To the left of that little tree, into the just the inside of the big tree. There's not much of a gap there, though. We set the par 5 14th hole. There's water down the left-hand side. You can see the fountain there in the distance.
Problems for Gladys Nocera on the par 5 14th.
Well, all sorts of things could go wrong here. Obviously, she's got two trees in her line, and then she's got water down the left-hand side if she doesn't get the ball to cut as well. Poor tee shot from her down that right hand side. Well, she's done it pretty well.
Hasn't tried to force the issue. Ball back in play.
Yeah, this very much a reachable, probably the most straightforward of the par fives. Oh, where Nocera stands on the tee, thinking, good chance to make another birdie. Also teeing off at the hole behind poorly was Holly Clyburn. Pretty fortunate to get a swing at this.
She has got a full swing at it, but right hand comes off. A little bit untidy for the last couple of holes from Holly Clyburn.
Another fairway miss from Trish Johnson. Playing a low chaser. Tournament nicely poised. I know it's only the first round, but McRae setting the standards, but great to see Charlie Hull performing so well again today. She got off to a slow start, but she really did fire with 5 birdies on her back nine, the front nine of this golf course. Clyburn slipping back, but hopefully she'll recover. And of course Nocera, well, not a good tee shot. As you say, took the medicine, still could end up making birdie here.
Well, this will be her third.
Another one of those with a two-tier green, pinned today at the back right portion. She's still got about a probably about 155 yards still in from here. You can see that yellow square marker. We've seen a few of those looks, haven't we, already in the last hour from Gladys Nocera.
I just wonder if her shoulder is bothering her.
Well, no signs of pain. Not physical, at least, anyway.
No, but not her usual consistent self. Clyburn, who wound up short of the green.
Yeah, the players are finding a little bit of inconsistency from some of the greens. Some of them are holding up pretty well, flying up. It sticks pretty quickly. Others are pretty firm and bouncy.
Florentina Parker yet to play. Her progress has been almost serene compared to the other two. In this hole at least. Distance control from Florentina Parker. Still these steady rain falls.
Johnson, who did drop a shot at the last hole. Just a wedge in for her third at this par five. And nicely done. Don't mind it. I mean, for the players, of course, it's raining, but not too heavily. But I think given the forecast that we had, which was for potential thunderstorms this afternoon, I think we can be pretty thankful we're seeing some play. Although, given the way she started this first round, I think Laura Davis wouldn't mind hearing the klaxon as she was heading out today. And she's struggling again.
On the 13th.
Did mention that Sarah shot 81 last year and only just finished outside the top 10, so it's the mindset Davis needs right now, but it's not going her way today. Not tee to green, not on the green. Derry missing out there. From one French lady to another.
Back to 14 and Gladys Nocera. Needs to get up the slope, and it has done. Nicely done. One of a few two-tiered greens on this golf course.
So they're just for par for Davis. I mean, she hasn't really been able to buy a putt so far today. And another one slips past.
Been very much the story, hasn't it?
And off the back of her first birdie of the day, back she goes to six over. Of course, Laura and Trish very much part of a number of Solheim Cups. Many fancied that when Florentina Parker first burst onto the scene. Maybe he was another potential Soham Cupper. She was only second to Anna Norquist as the Rookie of the Year in 2009. This is another lady who was second as Rookie of the Year. That was last year. Molly Clyburn to Charlie Holt. Double bogey, bogey, and all the hard work undone in a flash.
Good putt from Parker on 14. Still time for Florentina Parker, as far as Solheim Cups are concerned.
No, yeah, she's only 24.
But there is a tremendous group of young, talented players coming through.
Well, the Curtis Cuppers that we mentioned from the Great British and Ireland team in 2005. Here's Clyburn, one of them. We've obviously all know about Charlie Hull and Amy Bolden, who's playing here this week. Shot a three over par round today. Another mistake from Holly. Her game is suddenly falling apart, isn't it? She's, I think, got away with that one. Yeah, Amy Bolden won last week on the Access Tour.
She did.
And then you mentioned there's Lauren Taylor and Kelly Tidy, another few of the British players who are certainly ones to watch out for over the next few years. And of course, from the rest of Europe as well, plenty of talent. Clara Spilkova, who we watched this morning, play so well. She's played Junior Solheim Cup. She's played Junior Ryder Cup as well as Clara. Well, nice birdie from Trish, and she celebrated like an Arsenal winner. Second birdie of the day. Make the most of them.
For par for Nocera. And it rolls on by.
Well, there was I saying it was a hole, really. She'd be thinking birdie on Nocera. And she's going to walk away with a six. And all because of the error, really, off the tee. First drop shot of the day for the former Ladies European Tour number one. Well, it looks very much as if no one's going to catch Heather McRae, Nigel.
I think the
not
morning,
today, at least.
I think the morning was the best of the day, and Heather McRae has taken advantage of that and posted a wonderful round of 6 under par 67 to lead the tournament by two shots. And as Richard says, the afternoon players are struggling to get anywhere near that.
Yeah. It is raining pretty heavily right now, as hard as it has done all day. From one par five to another, and Trish Johnson taking up the driver here as she found the fairway. There's a big cluster of trees there down the left-hand side. From the way her body was shaping, as if she was maybe going towards them. They're thinking of maybe pushing the tee up here at 20 or 30 yards. And it'll probably be pretty comfortable for the players.
So you can take on that island of trees.
Yeah, it'll be more than possible to get over them.
Three wood for Florentina Parker.
The route is where Parker has gone right now, which is down that right-hand side. Makes the hole a little longer, but makes it safer too.
Third to go, Nocera. Safely on the fairway.
Well, it has been a shocker, hasn't it, for Laura Davis. And it goes from bad to even worse. There's a route there. And she's making into a three shot of a green she could have comfortably reached into with a decent tee shot. It's a shame to see someone who, of course, has played so much terrific golf over the years play as poorly as this today. I know Holly Clyburn, she was tweeting yesterday that she's going to play golf today with one of the heroes of the women's game, and that's very much how Laura Davis is seen. Not just amongst the players who play with her, but obviously those that are coming up and into the game. She has set the standards, not just, of course, on the Ladies European Tour, but, of course, across the Atlantic in America as well.
Oh, she's one of the best golfers England has ever produced.
Well, 7 times Order of Merit winner. It's very difficult, actually, to count up how many titles she has won, but, you know, all-time point scorer.
I think she's up to 79, isn't she?
Yeah.
I think around the world. I mean, she travelled extensively, and as you say, she plays golf in such an uncomplicated way. I mean, there's none of this standing over the ball for 5 minutes thinking about what you're going to do, and then 16 practice swings. Find it, hit it.
20 wins on the LPGA Tour is obviously not to be sniffed at. That's how things stand right now. Michaela Palmlid, comeback queen. She didn't retire for too long, did she? This is her first tournament of 2014 after supposedly retiring at the end of last year. Spilkova, the teenage talent, as is Charlie Holt, on the heels of Heather McRae.
Awkward life for Laura Davis. Changes her mind. She's got to get this on the green to have a chance of saving par. Disappear off the back.
Yeah. There is water off the back left, but she'll be fine. She won't be in the water, but there's plenty about, isn't there? Mainly out of the sky at the moment.
Yes, it's certainly getting heavier.
Typical, isn't it? Yesterday, beautiful sunny day, and round one gets underway, and the heavens open.
Parker, 2 under par. Keeping it together in the wet.
Yeah, it's just that slope there, you can see that the down slope that takes you down. It's around 120 yards from the green, so Johnson playing it nicely beyond that. Won't have a lot in.
That is a severe slope. Parker the next to go. Let's pick it up with Holly Clyburn, who is another one who has struggled.
Yeah, very important part of the round now for Holly Clyburn. It looked like it was going to be an excellent day for her. Nice shot there.
Pin high.
But important she finishes in a nice, strong manner. Just try and get herself in under par. Because really, I know we've seen a 6-under par score today, but it's just seeing to see. Laura did only avoid the water by a tad, didn't she? But I'm saying it'd be very hard to see anyone getting to 10 under par at the end of the week.
I think with the weather forecast, it's going to be very hard to replicate the sort of score that Heather McRae has put in today. And scoring tough at the best of times on this course.
But, I can't remember seeing Laura Davis have as many issues as she has today out on the golf course. That one left there, and she's lucky she didn't catch the slope and carry on down the hill there. It is left for her par at a reachable par 5. It's just a drive and a mid-iron really for Laura.
Same group is Valentine Derry.
Yeah, she's kind of had an uneventful day, Derry. She's no bad thing around this course. One birdie and one bogey.
Long putt for birdie. This to go one under. Work to do for her par.
Yeah, the golf at the moment a little bit like the weather, isn't it, really? Came here, promised much, but it's been a bit of a damp squib.
So Clyburn, who just needs a steady few holes.
Yeah, the goal for her, as I say, just try and get in under par. We'll be back with her in a moment. Meanwhile, Masera, a hole further up. Well, you expect when she's got a wedge in her hand for her to knock it within 15 feet at least. And job done.
Right at it. Masera in good shape. She's the closest of the three.
Well, this just for par for Laura Davis. And, when she missed that putt on 10, I think. Yeah, she can't even get that one. When she missed that putt on 10, I just felt that was a chance for any kind of momentum gone. And it's proved to be the case. She's slipping further and further down the leaderboard. We have seen some big numbers out there today. We've had a round of 81 from Carly Booth. Of course, only a couple of years ago, she was winning regularly on the Ladies European Tour at 80 from Sophie Gustafsson, one of Laura Davis's Solheim Cup teammates, 79 from Becky Brewerton. But Laura is heading for a number in the 80s as well, the way things are going. There he gets a par.
Steady stuff from Valentine Derry. Back to the 15th. Parker just off the green. Four behind the leader. And three to play after this one.
Yeah, it's the old saying, really, you can't win a tournament on day one. But like Laura Davis, you can play yourself out of it. But Parker, like the likes of Charlie Hull this morning, have certainly given themselves a platform to strike come the weekend. And then Trish Johnson battling away today. She got off to a very poor start, three bogeys in her first five holes, but she's dug in deep.
She hasn't had her A game, has she? But the experience comes to the fore. Holds it together and holds it together very well.
Back-to-back birdies and suddenly she's only one over. Not as big a celebration as she had on the last green, mind you.
But just as chuffed, I think.
She'd have been very annoyed, Nocera, with the way she played the previous par five. Birdie opportunity that turned into a bogey six for the 38-year-old from Biarritz. One of the Ladies European Tour players who's looking forward to playing at Pinehurst number two for the US Open. And she gets her birdie. Yeah, it's interesting. We got the
three off the lead.
Ladies European Tour event here this week. Challenge Tour event played on this very same course next week. And of course, it's kind of in reverse at the US Open, isn't it?
Well, the men's competition is taking place that week. And if there was a playoff, they have an 18-hole playoff on the Monday.
Yeah, so not a big chance for the ladies to get their practice in before they tee off on the Thursday.
Or the greenkeepers to
do their stuff.
There
have been one or two mumblings, shall we say, about that one.
Parker to stay at two under. Safely on the fairway from Valentine Derry on 15. On par five. Heather McRae leads on the first day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. A superb round of golf. Six under par.
Nathan Kerrigan.
Clara Spilkova and Michaela Palmlid leading the chasing pack after shooting 69s. Charlie Hull in the clubhouse with a 3-under par 70. The order of merit leader nicely placed. Further down the leaderboard, Nikki Campbell of Australia going well. 2-under through 9 holes. The veteran, Steffi Koch from Italy. 1-under par 72. The veteran, Jade Scheffler. 1-under through 12 holes. Same score as Chloe Lurker of Belgium.
Yeah, good to see Chloe doing well here. She actually is the last winner on this golf course.
She is. She won the Access Tour event at the end of last year, November.
Schaefer, a couple of times winner on the Ladies European Tour. Anke Lindner, of course, a winner last year. And one of the rookies, Krista Backer, there. Under par. And interesting to see, despite the struggles we've seen with some of the feature groups we've had, there are a fair chunk of players that are in the red figures.
There is a score to be had, but it's hard yards. Stacey Lee Bregman, who's been in fine form, recently won the Zambian Open. Level par today. Hannah Burke, another well-fancied player coming into the tournament. She too is shooting level par 73. Holly Clyburn, who we've been watching, along with Valentin Derry. A few holes for them, still to go. Back to coverage of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open, and Laura Davis on the 15th with driver from the fairway. It has been a struggle for Laura Davis this afternoon.
Yeah, just a bit. Yeah, now she won't be seeing the funny side of it right now. You can see she doesn't look too pleased with the way things are out there, and why should she? She feels like she's been playing okay recently, and this is not how to start your year on European soil.
Holly Clyburn and Valentin Derry, her playing partners, just about holding it together, those two. But it got away from Laura Davis very early on in the piece. And with her putter going cold, she's struggled to make any impact at all. On the 16th, with Florentina Parker. This is a par 3. And Nocera has found the edge of the green. Long putt for par.
managed to get within two shots of McRae. But of course, Gladys will have the opportunity, if she can post something in the 60s, to go out tomorrow morning and maybe get herself to the top of the leaderboard before you join us again for our coverage tomorrow afternoon, where we'll be following the likes of Charlie Holt. Oh, more issues for Laura Davis after hitting that driver off the tee. The backswing very much impeded here at 15. And yeah, she likes to attack. It's I think a case today of just looking for something to happen, something to act as a catalyst and retrieve an awful situation. But it's, I think, one of those days where it's just not going to happen for Laura. Close to being an excellent shot, but she's found the bunker.
Nocera for par on 16, stays at 3 under. Now that's Valentin Derry, who is on the fairway for her approach shot.
Yeah, she's only got about 60 yards to the hole here. I'm not sure she'll be able to hit a full wedge in, maybe. Yeah, it's a case of sometimes almost being too close in two, but she's played it very well.
Lovely control. Sets up a birdie opportunity.
There's been some terrific stories on day one. Unfortunately, not for the right reason for Laura Davis. Parker, though, despite a double bogey on this back nine, has a chance to get to four under, and she's taking it, so she's just two back. She really has a fabulous record here, and she's carrying that on this week, it would seem.
Playing with a lot of confidence, isn't she, Florentina Parker? Not so Laura Davis.
She's going to miss the cut, and the only upside for Laura is that she'll be able to very much focus on the end of the Premier League season. She went to a couple of Liverpool games this year. She went to the Manchester City game, where they won at home that emotional day on the anniversary of Hillsborough, and she also went to the game at Tottenham this season. Not easy when you're a full-time golfer to stick with your passions and be able to keep watching.
She's seen some good performances from Liverpool, though, hasn't she?
Yeah. Holly Clyburn. Isn't she a Liverpool fan as well, I think? I'm sure her and Laura have been discussing one or two things about the Anfield Club during this round.
Parker on 17. This has been the hardest hole on the course three of the last 4 years. It's very narrow. Parker has missed the fairway. Johnson 2 going with driver.
Yeah, it's a tough hole, tough driving hole, this 17th. Regularly plays as the hardest hole on the course. Too far left, you really are stuffed, and there's trees and water down the right-hand side. Trish is fine where she is. We've got a new fairway bunker as well down that right-hand side, too. 148 yards to reach it. Well, the pin's over on the right-hand side today. Well, sort of a back central right-hand side, so that's a pretty nice place to be down that left-hand side of the fairway for Nocera.
Derry. Putting uphill.
Yeah, nicely done from Valentin. It's interesting, they've got the Challenge Tour event here next week, and they have this event in France that she's played since, the one in Morocco where the men and women play together. PGA event in France, the Grand Prix.
To stay at eight over. Well, one's gone in.
Yeah, one not enough though. Not been much of that, has there, for Laura Sunshine. Longest of the par threes on the course. You won't have seen it there from where our camera started, but there is water to the back right and left portions of this green. 173 yards it is playing today, where the pin is, which means it's on the front portion of this two-tier green.
Derry with the honour.
Going about her business, isn't she, Derry? Well, this one's going left. Oh, my goodness.
Short of the waist.
Oh, dear, dear, dear.
It's a big miss. Smooth from Clyburn. Hitting into the upslope. Nice and straight.
It's a par 73 here, so at 8 over par. A couple of birdies required for Laura Davis to break 80.
Oh, be short.
Unlike her to be eight over par.
Very much so.
Done pretty well with it. Gladys Nocera. Now, I really don't understand why Caddy always lines her up, gives her the nod. I've yet to see, and I've watched her play a lot of golf shots, I've yet to see him say no and make a line up again. I hope you're not feeling dizzy, but that is Trish Johnson there.
Johnson trying to get inside Nocera, who's at 8 foot or so from the pin up the slope. Was required. An up and down day for Trish Johnson.
Yeah, a few players had that today. I mean, look at the round that Leanne Pace had earlier this morning. Defending champion, starting bogey, pulled it back, then she dropped couple of shots at the turn, then she had 4 birdies in a row to start the front nine, and then had a triple bogey 7 at the sixth. It all added up to a round of 75 for Leanne Pace, 3 over par. Now, I mean, Derry, I mean, the umpire very much signalled a wide on this one, didn't he? Well, the best thing you can say about that is she has a putt for par to come.
I don't think Valentine Derry would get that reference to the umpire calling a wide.
They
she?
Do play a little bit of
French
cricket in France, but
for birdie. It's a good putt.
Well, it's just about trying to gain some kind of respectability now for Laura Davis this week. Shouting out tomorrow morning and try and shoot the lights out, try and make the cut.
This runs away down the slope for Florentina Parker, who, given the conditions, is putting in a pretty good round of golf.
Yeah, I mean the conditions aren't that pleasant, I have to agree with you, Nigel.
But I mean, they're not unplayable.
But that's what I'm saying is that it's only a little bit wet. It's pretty mild, so it's not like you're cold, and there's no wind at all, and the greens are pretty receptive. I mean, I think it's fair to say there's just one or two players who haven't lived up to their capabilities, really. Cliburn certainly had it going early on, but she's yet to have a birdie on the back nine. And that's not going to change at 16. But if you get in a level par, you won't be overall disappointed. But I think given the way she began her opening round here, Cliburn, she will be little bit upset with the way things are going. So work to do for Parker and Johnson if they're to save their par at this tough 17th hole. And what's been a damp afternoon in Belek on the Turkish Riviera. Now, after making a right old hash of things on this hole, can Derry escape with a par? So back she goes to level par. Another putting for par here, Florentina Parker. Brother may well be playing next week in the Challenge Tour event here, Ben. Good save. I think Trish Johnson was having a good old look at that one as well. I get to see her smiling. Two under par. Johnson, this to stay at one over. Four years since her last win. Ladies European Tour titles, three wins on the LPGA Tour for Trish. Just the one under the belt for young Holly.
To stay at level par. Wins on tour for Nocera. Her last in China towards the end of last season.
Yeah, it was incredible. She'd gone 5 years without a win going into the start of last year. Of course, she more than made up for it in 2013, but a player of her talent. I know she had a little sojourn, as they say in France, off to the LPGA. I don't think she really enjoyed it that much.
Clyburn safely away.
It is their kind of weather, isn't it, really? Yeah, Laura says it's a 2-iron, 6-iron for her here at 17. And the 2-iron worked nicely.
Driver, it brings that new bunker into play, so she's got to stay left.
Fun hole of the day for Gladys Nocera. And a good closing hole, this 357 yards.
Water down the left.
Yeah, we'll water all the way down this left-hand side of this hole. So a good second shot coming up for Gladys. Often see siblings doing well. Of course, Lexi Thompson's brother obviously plays on the PGA Tour. Florentina's brother plays on the Challenge Tour. Of course, we've got the Clyburn girls out there, one playing, one caddy. Of course, I'm sure India would like to be out on the LET at some point soon.
Johnson with driver on 18. Left side of the fairway for Trish Johnson. Heather McRae continues to lead on the first day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. A superb round of golf, 6 under par, 67.
Cut it here, Laura. And she has it.
On 17, and it's...
middle stump. Another cricket reference.
Well, I wonder what kind of sight of the flag she will have, but... she's put herself in another awkward position. That smooth swing belongs to Valentin Derry.
Yeah, she did catch the green in off the cushion on that one. Giving you a snooker reference
snooker
this time, yeah. Well, it has been that time of year, hasn't it, really, to mention the snooker. Well, just missed the fairway, but... a good view of the green here at 17 for Holly Clyburn.
It's opened it up a little bit, hasn't it?
Another of the two-tier greens on this golf course. Pin today over on the lower portion, but towards the back of the green.
Safe.
Team Nocera down at 18. Awkward little patch here, rather muddy patch there that Nocera's landed on.
It's a very bare lie, isn't it? Gladys Nocera assessing her options on 18. She has a very bare lie.
Yeah, I think it's one of those days where you're pleased to get to 18. It's been pretty miserable weather-wise. The golf, especially for one or two, has been not to their high standards. And, well, an awkward shot coming up for Nicera. Obviously, needs to try and get a solid hit here. Water all the way down the left-hand side at this closing hole on the National Club in Belek.
Parker and Johnson both safely on the fairway. And Sarah and her caddy have had a long conversation about what to do.
Yeah, sometimes you do feel like it's too long a conversation, though. Taking a long time to work this one out, but hopefully it's going to be worth the wait. Well, I'm not sure she intended to put it that far left. It flirted with the water, didn't it? But she got away with it.
Looked like she might be laying up, but cut the corner of the lake and safely on the green with a birdie putt to come.
Oh, just dropped a shot at the last, Derry. That's nicely played. Yeah, from her position, I don't think it was a flag to get at. For Parker, though, it's certainly a pin to attack.
Much more straightforward for Florentina.
And now an awkward little bunker shot coming up. Got to come down that slope. Obviously, water waiting beyond.
Johnson, too, from the fairway.
That's how you do it.
Best of the three. Beautiful judgment.
Yeah, stuck with it today, hasn't she, Trish Johnson? Chopped a shot at the last to be at two over, but can hopefully pop that in for a round of 74.
Which sounds a lot, but it is a par 73.
On the wrong level, Clyburn up the slope at 17. She had a really good chance, didn't she, at the ninth hole when you just joined us, Holly Clyburn. From around 10 feet was to turn in 32 to go to 4 under. It looked like there was going to be no stopping her, and you can see she's starting to feel the frustration. We heard earlier from Heather McRae, didn't we? She wasn't getting carried away with her position. She knows it's only the first round, but she's set a mean target. I mean, Laura Davis fully 14 shots behind her. But a couple of terrific stories from this morning. Heather, who just by a matter of one shot missed out on her card last season through the second tier of the Ladies European Tour. Michaela Palmlid, who's in that tie for second, deciding at the end of last season to retire, then getting a call from the LPGA in America to tell her that she was part of Team Sweden in the international event that's coming up in a month. So she thought, okay, I fancy that, I'll start playing again. And shoots around a 69 in her first competitive round back.
Clyburn on 17. Stay level.
Well, it was that horror show at the par five, that double bogey that took her off path, and she hasn't really been able to get back on it since, has she?
Has to settle for bogey. Moves to one over. Been a frustrating day. Can't really take it out on your caddy when it's your sister.
Well, no. I have two older sisters, and they do like an argument now and again, don't they? But I don't think the golf course is the time and the place.
Now Parker, having overcooked her approach.
Yeah, I always find it. I mean, I think sisters is okay, but husband and wives, you know, when the wife caddies for the husband. I mean, it happens on the PGA Tour, it's happened on the European Tour, but it happens the other way around as well. I've seen, of course, Katrina Matthew famously, her husband Graham caddying for her many times, but you can imagine it can cause the odd bit of tension or two.
Sarah for birdie. Oh, yes.
Well, that wasn't a conventional birdie, was it, given where she put her tee shot?
She'll be delighted with that. What a way to finish.
Pulled a second, and it gets her in the clubhouse at 5 under par. A fabulous round of 68 from Gladys Nocera, one of the favourites coming into this week. And, well, that round certainly won't change that.
That's a marked improvement from last year for Nocera, who opened up with an 81.
And she still finished 12th then.
Yeah, so she's put herself in a very good position. She's had to work at it, though. Derry on 18.
Not quite as good as Brendan De Jong's comeback last week, was it, on the PGA Tour? He shot 80 in the first round, 62 in the second.
That would drive your psychiatrist nuts, wouldn't it?
Well, better to do it that way around than 62-80,
yes.
I think.
Yes. Ivan, having dropped a shot on 17, fails to find the fairway.
Over par, I'm afraid another English golfer, 8 over par, Mel Reid, who had an identical start to Davis with that double bogey beginning. Now Nocera, terrific birdie from her here. Can Johnson match her with a 3? She can. Well played.
Good,
she had
finish.
What a very good finish, particularly when you think she was 3 over par through 5 holes, so to get in at 1 over. I think job done for Trish Johnson.
Yes, a battling 1 over par for the veteran. Always has a natty lid, does Jade Schaefer.
Good look, isn't it, with
playing with
pastel blue,
Celine Herbert and Mel Reid.
playing nicely. Mentioned Regan poorly at 8 over. Schaefer at 1 over par. She did get it a couple under early on in the day, but just over for the two-time Ladies European Tour winner. It's been a good group, this. Johnson finishing just over par.
Parker for bogey, though.
Yeah. Struggled a little bit on her back nine, but still gets it in under par, Florentina Parker. And all set for another good finish here in Turkey.
Melissa Reed.
Yeah, she's been working hard with a new coach in the last few weeks, is Reed. And she didn't have any high expectations this week. I think it's going to take a little while for things to bed down. It certainly seems to be the case, doesn't it? Even the ducks having to take shelter from the weather we're having today.
It's rained pretty much all afternoon.
Celine Erban, who's coached by Sevi Ballesteros' brother Vicente, and of course yesterday marked 3 years to the day when Sevi unfortunately of course passed away.
Oh, that hit a good few trees.
Yeah, it's a lovely setting, not necessarily one to soak in the sunshine today, but it is a picturesque golf course, this National Golf Club. A lot of good golf courses around in and around the surrounding area. And I think it's probably a good day for everyone to come and watch rather than be out there playing.
Clyburn with water between her and the flag. Has she got the right club? Yes, she has.
Come on, come off the slope. Oh, it's going to stay there. That's unfortunate for Laura.
Two excellent shots.
Yeah, I don't think a birdie's going to cheer up too much, though.
Derry trying to make it a hat trick. Safe.
Got a lot to look forward to this week. Obviously, tomorrow we'll watch and see if Charlie Hull can continue to, no longer surprise us all, but continue to show the talent she has. I think she was rather nonplussed by her round today, but a very good effort, 3 under par. Getting it, finishing off with a birdie. She's nicely positioned, isn't she?
How it stands, Gladys Nocera chasing down Heather McRae, who this morning shot a wonderful 6 under par, 67, to lead on the opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. The amateur Mathilde Capelier of France, who performed so well in Morocco, the 15-year-old, 2 under through 9 holes. Yeah, another young talent making her way on the LET.
Yeah, I saw Nicky Campbell was at 3 under par as well. Australian, who's of course played quite a lot in Japan and
very
also
experienced
in America. So obviously one to watch out for the rest of the week. She's still got 6 holes left to play of her opening round, but 3 under. 5 under the best of the afternoon scorers. That was Gladys Nocera, who we just saw finish off on this hole with a birdie. And there's 3 possibilities of birdie in this group on the 18th.
Derry the first to go. Played down the wrong line. So par at best for Valentine Derry, her compatriot. Jade Schaefer, her approach to the 17th. Just over the bunker. Next to go on the 18th is Laura Davis. No birdie for Laura Davis on the 18th.
And I think it's a day that, in what's been a glittering career, that will go out of the memory bank as quickly as possible for Laura Davis's sake. It's been a bit of a horror show. Oh, and that one only just about dropped in. It's around in the 80s for Laura Davis.
9 over par.
I actually think she finished at 8 over. We saw a birdie, didn't we, that par 5 12th. So I think we've done her out of one. I mean, 82 is bad enough.
No, if it's 82, then...
But 81, I think it was.
Confirmation of that to come. Former champion, Melissa Reed.
Yeah, won here in 2010.
Now Clyburn for birdie on 18. Get back to level par. Took a bobble.
Well, a round of high promise. Turns into a mediocre 74 for Holly Clyburn. Still very much in the hunt for the title.
Yeah, it's not out of it by any means. Leanne Pace last year had a 77 on her way to the title. It was in the second round. ...73 for Valentine Derry. Holding it together on a difficult afternoon.
Yeah, I don't think you'd have had too many people thinking that maybe Derry would outscore both Clyburn and Laura Davis, but that's what the Parisian has done with that round of 73. Well, for Laura Davis tomorrow, it's all about making the cut, isn't it? Now, a lot of work for her to do if she is going to do that. Derry and Clyburn, it's trying to chase down that 6 under par leading score that we've got from Heather McRae at the top.
back to 17, and Selina Urbain with her third shot.
Another who's had a difficult day, Nigel. Six over par, just bogeyed 15 and 16.
Come on. Putt for par for Urbain.
Yeah, it looked like she might win in Spain last year, didn't she? She was leading going into the
a very good
final
first
round.
Three rounds, yeah.
She actually lives in Spain, doesn't she, even though she's from France? And then a good old clean.
Reed. Up the slope. She'll have that for par.
Yeah, she admits, Melissa Reed, it's been a tough time for her, really. Struggled to rediscover her appetite for the game. It's only, of course, a couple of years since that tragic incident in Germany when her mother unfortunately died. And you can understand that perspective might not be what it was for Melissa. I think she'll get that hunger back. Good to see she's trying different things, working with a new coach now, maybe just
she's
trying to...
She's quite open about her sort of different priorities in life. She's reading an article in the Derby Evening Telegraph. She's a local girl in Derby, and but out here plying her trade. It'll come. Schaefer.
Yeah, because when she won here in 2010, it just seemed like that was just the natural way of things. It was a matter of time. She'd come close to winning a few times before that. She had 10 top tens as well that same season.
She's a tremendous athlete, isn't she? I mean,
she's a good footballer as well. She plays in, I think, in like the second tier of the Women's Professional League in England.
She'd probably get in the Derby team, wouldn't she?
Yeah. Well, you're talking about the men's team now, aren't
yeah.
you?
Oh, this for bogey.
Yeah, I think that was her favourite bit of the Evian Championship, was playing in the football match that they have on the Thursday night there. Laura Davis plays it every year as well. Although Mel, one year she was leading after the first round, played in the football match and got herself injured.
To stay eight over. Like Laura Davis, her focus tomorrow will be on trying to make the cut.
Yeah, she's made the cut in all five editions of this tournament previously.
Schaefer remains at one over par. As they move to the 18th hole. And the toughness of the golf course reflected in some of the scores today. Some of the big names shooting big scores.
Yeah, we kind of come to expect it, don't we, at this golf course, that we're going to see some big numbers. Although, 81 from Carly Booth and matched by Laura Davis, 80 from Sophie Gustafsson. Established winners, but if you're not on your game, if you're offline here, you are going to get severely punished. But as you can see from those girls there, the comeback kid Michaela Palmlid and teenager Clara Spilkova, Gladys Nacera, of course, a couple of wins for her last year, and Heather McCrae with one of the best rounds this course has seen, just one outside the course record of 66.
I think it stopped raining. Oh, I can still hear it. Yeah. And the brollies are still up.
Yeah, it's good to see Heather McCrae performing so well at the start of the year, because she felt like 2013 was her best year as a pro. And you want to try and kick on from that.
Well, there was a little clue at the Lala Meriem in Morocco. She had a second round 68. There is a bit of form in there, and it's putting it together on a consistent basis, but she's made an excellent start to this tournament. And on a tough golf course like this, a 67 is fabulous.
Fine tee shot from Schaefer, safely on the fairway at 18. Last win coming in the Czech Republic 3 years ago.
Top 10 finish in 2010 for Schaefer, same year that Mel Reid won, and she's gone offline.
She's actually level par on the back nine, Mel Reid, which shows you how badly things went wrong on the front. Yeah, Ben, off the back of two bogeys and then a double in the last three holes. So some real struggles for one or two players out there.
Fairway.
Yeah, it's been interesting to see how the players prepare for this. For Mel Reid, it's just been practice. She didn't play the event actually in Morocco. It was her sister's wedding. Obviously, she wanted to be there for that. Whereas you've got players like Spilkova, who played last week in the Access event last week, and obviously showed some good form, finishing fourth there. You've got players like Holly Clyburn, who spent a couple of weeks out in Florida. Charlie Hall, of course, has been playing in one or two events like Nacera at the Craft Nabisco and a few events on the LPGA. But you think you're getting things going here. I think Stephanie Nahl's round today sums things up. She went to the turn in 32, 5 under par, but she came back in 42. For a round of 74, one over par for the player who was runner-up last week on the Symetra Tour in America. So even when you think you got things going, as we saw from Holly Clyburn, there could be something to trip you up. Maria Balakova, formerly known as Vershinova, of course, going along okay today. She knows this course pretty well as well. She used to come here as a young girl.
Because obviously practice.
It's not easy to obviously play golf in the winter in Russia. So she used to come from the age of 12 to Turkey and use the facilities here.
Popular destination for Russians, this part of Turkey.
Sure.
That's the view from the clubhouse behind the 18th green.
So this is Maria Balakova now live with us at this par 3 16th. She's been working very hard on her short game. Let's see if it comes to some kind of fruition here. Yeah, pretty good.
Not too bad. She had a top 10 finish in 2010.
And she did well to win her car back last season. She only played in a handful of events, but finished fourth in the Czech Republic. She really does feel like her game has improved a lot over the last couple of years. Interesting hearing a quote from her, and I think there'll be a few women that will look at this and think, what? She says she struggles to put on weight. And she's been trying to bulk up a bit, trying to get a bit more distance, but not a bad problem here to have, is it? Struggling to put on weight?
Played a couple of events as Balakueva so far this season.
I think Mel Reid might need this signage board removed.
Is she checking the local rules?
Yeah, she can move it.
Yeah, she can. No such problems for Jade Scheffler.
Flirted with the water, but Schaefer in with a birdie opportunity here at the last.
A good shot, even though it was an unorthodox finish to the swing.
Fair chance to get in at level par.
Next to go is Urbain. Excellent. So birdie opportunity for Urbain.
And after her awful run the last few holes, maybe a chance to make things a little better there at 18. Maria for par. Very much got this image as the Maria Sharapova, or the Anna Kournikova of golf. But yeah, she's shown over the last year there's some talent there, and working very hard to make herself a Ladies European Tour winner.
Well, as I was saying, you know, she's 42nd in the order of merit after two events, so she does have some form.
She says actually when she plays in Japan, they shout at her, Sharapova, Sharapova. She's Russian, she's a sportswoman, eh? It'll do.
It's close enough.
It's raining even harder maybe than it was for the rest of this afternoon. Well, it's not far for a referee to go if they're in the clubhouse.
She's looking at that telegraph pole.
Maybe so. Well, Mel Reid's going to take a little while, I think, to sort this one out.
I gives us an opportunity to bring you up to date with the state of play as we come towards the end of the first day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open. Heather McRae out in the morning, shooting a wonderful 67, 6 under par. She leads by a shot from Gladys Nocera. Matilda Capellier of France, 2 under par through 9 holes as we go back to Mel Reid. The bedraggled spectators in the background.
They've braved the weather, haven't they, Nigel?
Yeah, credit to them. It's wonderful.
Unfortunate though, just on the wrong level. Could have caught the slope and come back down, but
it's a pretty good shot. She had a lot of time to think about it. Right, birdie opportunity for Mel Reid. I think Derby are in the playoffs, aren't they? Did they reach the playoffs?
I think you're right.
Well, you should know about the championship. Your team are going to play in it next season.
Let's move on very swiftly to Maria Balakova.
Coming towards the end of the first day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open, Mel Reid, the 2010 champion, will have a putt for birdie on the 18th. She's had a difficult round.
Yeah, well, I mentioned earlier, Stephanie Nahr went 32-42 for her round of 74. Well, Mel shot 43 on her front nine. She's got this actually to be back in one under par.
Get her to 7 over. Has she read it right?
Yeah, very much part of the Solheim Cup winning team in Killeen Castle. And should have loved to have been there in Colorado as well, but needs to get her game back into groove. Cool set. St. Leon Rot will be the destination for next year's Solheim Cup. Karin Koch and Julie Inkster are named as the captains.
Lining up her putt is Jade Scheffer of France. This too is for birdie. thought about it. She'll stay one over.
Well, she came out the blocks fast, three birdies in her first five holes, Schaefer, but finishes with a round of 74. I'm afraid.
Pops it in for par. Ball goes in the water. Birdie for Celine Urban. Wonderful approach shot. But she too has had a torrid afternoon.
Yeah, that makes it, I make it 18 players now who have failed to break 80 out on the course so far today. And of course, not everyone's finished yet. Which maybe gives you a little bit of perspective of Heather McRae, 67 at the top. Just one bogey from Heather today, seven birdies to stand at 6 under. Well, we saw her go down the right hand side, Balakueva. I'm afraid she's going to have to take an unplayable. Now, I mentioned she used to come out here and practice. She's now based in Dubai.
Just checking on where to take the drop.
She knows this course so well.
This area of Turkey has become something of a mecca for golfers over the last decade or so. The National was the first course built in 1994. And it is the number one course in the area.
Big events, of course. First time there's going to be a Challenge Tour event here. Last year was the first European Tour event. Tiger Woods was in town, of course, hitting it from one continent to another on the bridge and making headlines around the world. Of course, Victor Dubuisson winning that part of the final series on the European Tour, and they'll be back at the Montgomery course for that. Three events on this course, one on Ladies European Tour, one on the Access Tour, and as I mentioned, on the second tier of for the Europe event.
Here's how it stands as the end of the opening day of the Turkish Airlines Ladies Open nears. Heather McRae leading the way with a superb 6 under par 67. And after that magnificent round of golf, we caught up with the Scot.
6 under today, what a fantastic start to the tournament for you.
Yeah, it was really pleasing. It's nice to get out early on the first day and just hold a good putt for par on 10 and then birdie the next couple of holes. So it just kind of tried to stay calm and take one shot at a time, and it's turned out pretty good. So
this is a course you actually know a little bit better than many. You did well here in the Access Series. In fact, almost a repeat on the first day then as the first day now.
Yeah, I played November last year in the Access Tour, and I think the first round is some of the best golf that I've played. So it was, I think that helped me a lot today with standing on the tees and knowing that I've hit good shots and hit good shots into the greens. And yeah, it's a nice place. It's a great golf course, and it's just got a nice feel about it. So
that's a big event, and you're winning by 2 shots currently, I believe. B but you seem so relaxed. Are you really relaxed, or is this just an act for me?
No, I am, but I think it's good because, as I say, when I was here in the Access event last year, and I was leading after the first day and kind of getting a tour card was hanging in the balance, I got so kind of stuck in the moment and just got so nervous. So I mean, it's only Thursday, I have to remember that, and there's still a long way to go and there's still people just teeing off just now, so it's a bit early to get excited.
We'll get excited for you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Well, Heather McRae was leading by two shots for most of the afternoon, but one of the more experienced members of the field had something to say about that. With Gladys Nocera putting together another excellent round of golf.
Yeah, a couple of birdies on the front nine at 6 and 9 from Gladys. Didn't make birdie from that approach to 10, but it was part of the lovely golf we saw from her. Look at this wedge in to the par 5 12.
Lovely control. And she took the chance. She had her moments, though, did Nocera, but when the opportunities presented themselves, she took advantage.
Cheetah Green, she is among the best on the Ladies European Tour, isn't she? And again, setting up a lovely chance at 13. Couldn't take that, then made a mess of 14, but bounced back superbly with this birdie at 15.
And from a difficult lie, a superb shot to the green. And it was a long putt for birdie for the veteran French lady. But in it went. 5 under par. 68 for Gladys Nocera. She talked to us afterwards.
Yeah, I mean, I missed two drives and I was behind the tree. So this course is really tricky. And with the rain today, it makes it even harder.
And just talk to me a little bit about 17 and 18. A couple of birdies on the way in. What a lovely way to finish.
Yeah, 17, I hit a good drive on the left-hand side and hit my 5-iron like a meter and a half away, made the putt, and on 18, I mean, I didn't expect to make the putt. I mean, it was a big, big sloppy putt, and I made it, so it's nice.
Gladys Nocera, going to be a contender over the next 3 days. Somebody else who will contend without question is Charlie Hull.
Yeah, she's always exciting to watch, isn't she, Charlie? Likes to play her shots. And that was at the par 5 fourth hole. She really had a quiet front nine for her, starting at the 10th. Had one birdie, one bogey, but plenty of fireworks. Just two pars coming back. Winner, of course, on her last adventure on the Ladies European Tour. Morocco's had a near miss at a major since then as well. And she closed out in some style as well. This her approach to the ninth. At this stage, 2 under par for the day. And managed to put it to 10 feet. And she always seems to deliver.
Charlie Hull, right in the mix. After that 3 under par round of 70, she went out in the morning. She had the best of the weather, as did Heather McRae. And boy, did she take advantage with that round of 67. Gladys Nocera showing all her experience. One shot back. Spilkova, the teenager from the Czech Republic. Michaela Palmlid from Sweden, the veteran. Both chasing hard at 4 under par. Then Hull and the experienced Australian Nikki Campbell on 3 under. Terrific day for Sarah Hassan of Wales, 2 under 71. Further down the leaderboard, Nicole Brock-Larsen of Denmark, a rookie, 2 under par. Capellier of France, the 15-year-old, 2 under par, still out on the course. Stacey Lee Bregman, level par. Hannah Burke, also level par. It's been a difficult day the golfers.
I think fair to say, as you can see, they're only 20 players under par, and once again the National Golf Club here in Belek has come out on top, if you like. But a super round today at 6 under par. I think we've got lots to look forward to tomorrow, especially seeing if Charlie Hull can reel in the leader.
More surprises in store for tomorrow, no doubt, and over the next 2 or 3 days. My thanks to Richard Kaufman from all of us here in Turkey. It's bye for now.